You asked for it, so here's a step-by-step guide to creating a different kind of ad on Amazon, an Amazon keyword advertisement. Hello, writers in training. I'm Shanon, writing under the pen name SD Houston and author of Blood of the Lily. And welcome to my channel where I show writers like you how to develop your writing skills and self-publish your work. Creating this type of ad takes a bit more work. So with that in mind, I am breaking this concept into a two-part video where I will set up a new ad for my book, Blood of the Lily. For this first video, let's go find some keywords. The best way to create a keyword ad is to generate keywords first. Brian Cohen said in his free 5-day Amazon Ad Profit Challenge class that you want to have between 100 and 150 keywords. Brian says the closer to 150 is better, but try not to go over 150 as he's found in his experience that it's not as effective. As I don't know much about making Amazon ads, I'm relying at this time on Brian's expertise. So all my knowledge here comes from him. Keyword ads vary in type. First are keywords that describe your novel, like YA fantasy, coming of age fantasy, fairy tale retelling. As I've already set up an ad like that on my book, I won't show how to set up another one. I'm not sure I have another 150 words I can come up with to describe my novel. Two other types of keyword ads are using similar book titles or using similar author names. We'll work on setting up an ad with similar book titles. Note that one book title equals one keyword. Let's start with a preliminary step. To find good, comparable book titles, it helps to know your book categories. So you'll want to start with this step of knowing your book categories. You can see up to 3 on your Amazon book page, but you may have more. You can use Publisher Rocket to see these, or use the free website bklnk.com. By putting in your ASIN or ISBN-10 number into this free site, you'll see all your categories. I'll use my book here, Blood of the Lily. Here are my book categories. It's a good idea to mark down your categories. I would open a document or a spreadsheet in whatever program you have and put them in. Now we have our book categories. Next, we need to generate those book titles for our keywords. There are multiple methods of finding and generating keywords for your ads. Here I'll share 3, but note that the third one is my favorite. Number 1, Publisher Rocket. The first way to find keywords is by using Publisher Rocket. Publisher Rocket is designed to help self-publishers build a solid, profitable book business based on real data collected from Amazon. Once I'm in Publisher Rocket, then I can go to Competition Analyzer. Here, I'm going to choose ebook since the ad I'm going to create will be for my ebook, and I will put in one of my categories. It will now bring up a list of books that either fall into the same category or they use some of my words as their keywords. I will just have to go through and figure out which ones are comparable to mine. And I'd probably hit load more here, and I would probably keep loading more and more until I have a good size list of books. Once I have my list of books, then I'll come up here and hit export competition data. And now I have a list of titles here in the first column. Now I would have to clean up this list because Amazon doesn't like different characters, like the parentheses. And of course, you want to go through and take out any of these books that would not be comparable to yours. So it takes a little bit of time to weed through everything. Now I could go back to Publisher Rocket and do a new search and search for another category and come up with more books. Remember that we want to have anywhere from 100 to 150 book titles by the time we're done. I'll stop here for now as I prefer method 3. The con of this method is that it costs money. However, the next two methods don't cost money, but method number 2 is more labor intensive in my opinion. Number 2, Amazon search. This is mostly tedious work. The pro to this tedious work is that you can control each keyword you mark down. There is an easier way, at least it is in my opinion, which is method 3, but the con to number 3 is that you have to scrub various lists, which can be just as tedious depending on what returns, but I'll go to number 3 in just a moment. Let's look at this one first. Go to your book category on Amazon. There are a few ways to get there, but you'll want to go to the bestsellers list in your category. Here you can click on bestsellers, scroll down until you get to Kindle Store, Kindle eBooks. Then I start narrowing it down by my category. First is teen and young adult, then science fiction and fantasy, fantasy, coming of age. Now here is one of my categories. Once I'm on the right page, I'll look one by one through each book title, and I'll evaluate if my book is comparable to those books. If they are, I will mark down the title. And this part is truly subjective, so you need to understand what you write and how that compares to other books. Another thought to this, but not something everyone subscribes to, is that I don't want to choose any really big name titles because the cost of that particular keyword will be higher, as everyone will want to use big ticket books to catch more readers. I don't plan to set my bid very high, so if I choose a keyword that has higher bids, then I'll never be found using that keyword, as I will never win that bid, and I will have wasted a keyword. Unless I want to pay more, it makes sense to choose books with less clout. So that knocks out Harry Potter books. As you go through, if you see something that you don't recognize, go through and look at the blurb of the book. See if some part connects to your story. The question you want to ask yourself is, if a reader reads this book on the bestseller list, will they also enjoy reading my book? If the book in question is very different from yours, they may not. Again, this is subjective. You have to make the decision, but don't beat yourself up or let it stall your progress. As I mentioned in my video, 5 Tips I Learned About Amazon Ads from Brian Cohen's class, these are first generation ads. In a sense, testing ads. When you run the ad on Amazon, you'll see which clicks you get on those titles or keywords. If you have a correlating sale that day, then you know you've hit on a good title. And now you have a baseline for comparable books and you can make more ads. Before moving on to number 3 and my preferred method of finding keywords, if you're finding value in this content, please work out that like button. Number 3, Instant Data Scraper. For this type of keyword search, you need to download and install the free extension, Instant Data Scraper. Make sure to get the exact one for this, as I don't know how the others work. This extension can reliably grab keywords for most websites. The scraper allows you to collect thousands of keywords in a matter of minutes. Instant Data Scraper works best on sites that have lists of a lot of books, and one of the best examples of this is Goodreads Listopia. Listopia's user-generated collections of book titles serve as a solid resource of keywords. I've used a lot of the Listopias already, so we're going to try this on Amazon. Once I'm on the page I want to gather data from, I click the Instant Data Scraper icon. You may have to refresh the page if Chrome prompts you to do so. Once inside Data Scraper, check the information the plugin has crawled. If it's the list you want, then click Locate Next button. If not, click Try Another Table until you select the list of books. After clicking Locate Next button, use your pointer to find the next button on the page, located at the bottom of Amazon. Then click Start Crawling. Once you've collected your keywords, you can click CSV or XLSX to download the file and open it in Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets. Open the document to check out your brand new list of targets. You'll have to clean the column with the book's titles because Amazon doesn't like keywords with parentheses or asterisks. Next, you'll want to look through your list and remove any obvious, irrelevant book titles like we did for number 2. It's likely this list of 100 book titles will be whittled down, so I'll repeat all of this with my next category until I get at least 150 book titles for my keywords. So those are the 3 ways to find keywords for an advertisement. Tomorrow I'll post part 2 where I'll show you how I set up my keyword Amazon ad using our findings from today. I'll also talk about Brian Cohen's next free class. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and happy writing.